In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, God's good people. Today is Friday, the 30th of April, 2021. It is Friday of the fourth week of Easter, Church Year B. We thank God for bringing us to the end of this month of April. You are listening to Catholic Meditation with me, your servant, Father Blessed Ambang Njume. Thanks for joining us. Let us pray. O God, author of our freedom and of our salvation, listen to the voice of our pleading and grant that those you have redeemed by the shedding of your Son's blood may have life through you and under your protection rejoice forever unharmed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, verses 26 to 33. The psalm is taken from Psalm 2, and the response to the psalm is, "You are my Son. It is I who have begotten you this day." The Gospel is taken from St. John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 6. I read from the Gospel. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The theme for today's meditation is Jesus is the way to heaven. Jesus is the way to heaven. Beloved of God, in today's gospel passage, Jesus uses one of the I am phrases again. Today he says, I am the way. No one can come to the Father unless through me. John chapter 14 verse 6. What was the context within which Jesus said so? He had been telling the apostles that his time on earth was coming to an end. That was after his resurrection. He had come and died on the cross to fulfill the Father's will. The time was coming for him, therefore, to return to the Father. So he told them not to be troubled. They were going to miss him, yes. But after going, he will return to take them to his Father's house, where there are many mansions. He told them he had to go first to prepare the place, then they would follow later. It was Thomas who asked him, "We do not even know where you are going, so how can we possibly follow you? We do not even know the way." Thomas was thinking of some physical road or some means of transport. But Jesus answered, "I am the way, the truth, and life. No one can come to the Father except through me." John chapter 14, verse 6. This means the road to the Father, the means to reach heaven, is Jesus. Dear friends, for those who drive or ride or fly planes, you cannot get to a destination if you do not know your way. How do you even begin to drive to nowhere? So before you enter a car to drive, two things. One, you have a destination. And two, you know exactly the road that will lead you there. On earth, we are pilgrims. We are on a journey, and our destination is heaven. Now, Jesus says he is the way, the road that will take us there. Unless you have a different destination, then you do not need to go through Jesus. But if heaven is truly and indeed your destination, then you had better buy your ticket and board Jesus Travel Agency. You may want to go by air, or by sea, or by land, but Jesus is the way to the Father. Jesus is the way to heaven. By this, Jesus means, if you want to reach heaven, do all he asks of you and all he tells you. If you do that, then you are on the right path to the Father. You are on the right path to heaven. Failure to follow Jesus, then you have missed your track. You are following a wrong road, and you will definitely get to a wrong destination. Every good Christian should begin by asking himself or herself, am I on a journey? And if yes, because of course it is, we know we are passing by. No one came here on earth to remain. This world is not our home. We are en route. Therefore, we are on a journey. The next question is, where is my destination? Do I really want to get there? How do I get there? And what is that way that Jesus says he is to lead us to heaven? One, it is the way of suffering. Unless you take up your cross and follow me, Jesus says, you cannot be a true disciple. You cannot make heaven. Luke chapter 9 verse 23 and Matthew chapter 16 verse 24. Beloved, it is as simple as that. A Christian who does not accept suffering, a Christian who does not accept the way of the cross, is definitely on the wrong road. I remember as kids while growing up, we were told that there were two roads. One, very stony and rocky, the other very smooth. It was a way of telling us that the rocky and stony road is the one that leads to heaven, because definitely the road to heaven is not smooth. The numbers of difficulties you have to go through, the persecutions you have to go through. But beloved, if you want it all smooth, then you have chosen the road that leads to hell. Second, the road that Jesus is that leads to heaven is the way of love. Matthew chapter 5 verse 44. If you hate, if you keep enemies and cannot forgive, then you are definitely on the wrong road. For Jesus says, unless you love your enemies, love all, and pray for those who persecute you, then, dear friends, as simple as that, you are on the wrong road. But when you love and you are ready to forgive, then you are on the right road. You are on Jesus' road that leads you to heaven. The road that leads to heaven, that is Jesus, is the road of detachment. Beloved, unless we are ready to deny ourselves, Matthew chapter 16 verse 24, we cannot make heaven. And what does it mean to deny ourselves? To deny ourselves of every pleasure that is tempting and that leads to hell. To deny ourselves of our ego. To deny ourselves of our will. To deny ourselves, beloved, of those things that take us away from God. Unless we are ready to detach. Jesus himself detached. He denied himself even of his glory. Philippians chapter 2 verses 6 to 11. God's good people, until and unless we are like Jesus and act like him and talk like him and follow his ways, then I am sorry, we will not make heaven. But when we talk like him and act like him and do the things that he asks of us, then we are on the right path that leads to heaven. For Jesus is the way that leads to heaven. And if heaven is truly your destination, then follow Jesus. Do what he says and act as he did. And I tell you, you are just on the right way to heaven. This is what all the saints did, and now they are in heaven. If you too want to go to heaven, follow Jesus. And I tell you, heaven will be sure for you. A blessed Friday. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever. Amen.